Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the Syncfusion React ComboBox component using the Create React App command. I will also show you how to configure a few of the control's basic features, like binding list and remote data, and customizing pop-up height and width. Let me show you the application creation process. First, I create the app using the Create React App toolchain and use VS Code as the editor, and show the output in Chrome browser. Now, I create a new application in command prompt using the npx create react app command and provide the app name MyReactApp. I set the script version to template TypeScript. Next, navigate to the desired location and run this example using the npm start command. Now, I can edit the app.tsx page to show the ComboBox component. Next, I open the project in VS Code and remove the default code snippets from the app.tsx file and remove the styles from the app.css file. Then import the material theme styles to apply them to the ComboBox component. Then, I install the ComboBox package using the command npm install syncfusion ej2 react dropdowns. To start using the ComboBox component, I import it from the EJ2 React dropdowns package and include the ComboBox component tag. Add placeholder property and set the value as select a game. Then, add a few styles to align the ComboBox component. Let me run this application. See, the ComboBox component is rendered. And you can notice, no records are displayed when I click the drop-down icon. Data can be bound to the ComboBox component using the DataSource property and assign the array of string values, such as badminton, cricket, football, golf, and tennis. While binding the data, I also need to map the data fields to the text and value fields of the ComboBox component. For this array of simple data, both text and value fields will be considered the same. Let's see the output now. Look now, when the drop-down icon is clicked, the array data will be listed. I can also bind a JSON array to the ComboBox component. I will define a JSON object, naming it SportsData. Then I define the object values with two fields, ID and Game. I assign this JSON object to the DataSource property. Then, I need to map the JSON object fields to the value and text fields of the ComboBox component using the fields property. Here, I map the ID to the value field and game to the text field. See here, the ComboBox pop-up list values are shown based on a JSON object. To bind remote data, I use the Syncfusion Data Manager. I import the data manager from the namespace syncfusion ej2 data. Then, I declare the variable remote data and create an instance of the data manager to provide the service endpoint URL using the URL property. I assign the remote data link. To make the server understand the request and process the response, we need to specify the adapter type. You can refer to the different adapter types in the UG link provided in the description below. Here I use the Web API adapter. Import it from the Syncfusion EJ2 data package and use it in the adapter. Then enable the cross-domain option. I assign this variable to the data source property. Then I map an employee ID to the value field, the first name field from remote data to text field. Declare another variable, data query, and create an instance of query to specify the column name to fetch from the remote data. Assign this to the query property in the ComboBox component. Check now in the ComboBox pop-up list shows the remote data. Finally, let's see how to set custom values in the pop-up height and width. By default, pop-up width adjusts to ComboBox input element width and height set to 300 pixels. I include pop-up height property and set a custom value. Include pop-up width property and set a custom value. See now, the pop-up height and width have been customized. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to configure the Syncfusion React ComboBox component using the Create React App command. I also showed you how to configure a few of the control's basic features, like binding list and remote data, and customizing pop-up height and width. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.